Great heaven, whose mighty frame no respite knows, maker of all from whom the world arose, hear, bounteous parent, source and end of all, forever whirling round this earthly ball, abode of gods, whose guardian power surrounds the eternal world with ever-during bounds, whose ample bosom and encircling folds the dire necessity of nature holds. Ethereal, earthly, whose all various frame, azure and full of forms, no power contain. All-seeing heaven, progenitor of time, forever blessed, deity sublime, propitious on this rite of union shine, and crown their wishes with a life divine. Please join me and turn to the east. For centuries, humanity has seen the sun rise in the east and has seen light come into the world from the east. From that direction, we have thought, the powers of reason and logic have come. Powers of the east, we invite you.
Let me speak for the East, and let me ask, do you intend to support one another in your intellectual pursuits and the growth of your knowledge? Will you seek to support one another in solving difficult problems together?
We will.
Then may the powers of the East bless your wedding day and the marriage that is to come.
Please join me, and let us turn to the South. For it is in the south that the sun reaches the height of midday, and the heat of life runs hot.
Let me speak for the south. Do you plan to support one another's passions and enthusiasms? Do you promise to assist each other in achieving your dreams and pursuing your heart's desire together?
We will.
And may the powers of the south bless your wedding day and the marriage that is to come.
Then let us turn past the west to the north. Okay. For it is from the north that the harder realities come.
Let me speak for the north. Will you share in one another's substance and wealth? Will you look after one another in ill health and old age? Will you provide for one another and help maintain a common household?
We will.
Then may the powers of the North bless your wedding day and the marriage that is to come.
Let us continue to turn all the way around to the West. For it is in the West that the deepest mysteries of the heart arise at the close of day.
Let me speak for the West. Do you love one another and cherish one another? Do you love one another?
We do.
Let me say on. For life is long and love takes many forms in a long life. Will you love and cherish each other in all ways? Will you care for one another and turn your hearts toward one another all your days? Will you let your love be a shared ocean, one that you cross together?
We will.
And may the powers of the West bless your wedding day and the marriage that is to come. Enter in joy, remain in bliss all of your days.
With holy voice we call the stars on high, pure sacred lights and genie of the sky, celestial stars, the progeny of night, in whirling circles beaming far your light. Refulgent rays around the heavens you throw, eternal fires, the source of all below. With flames significant of fate you shine, and aptly rule us for a path divine. In seven bright zones ye run with wandering flames, and heaven and earth compose your lucid frames. With course unwearied, pure and fiery bright, forever shining through the veil of night. Hail, twinkling, joyful, ever-wakeful fires, propitious shine on all your just desires. These sacred rites regard with conscious rays, and end your works devoted to your praise.
Today, we are here to join Christopher and Lisa in marriage, and to share in the joy of this occasion, which will be one of the most memorable and happy days of their lives. Right now, Canon and Sydney Marshall would like to share a poem with you.
This poem is called "Love is a Handful of Honey" by Giles Andrea. Love is that warm, cozy feeling, a cuddle that tells you you're sweet. And love is that feeling of laughing out loud when somebody tickles your feet. Love is a handful of honey and loves making friends with the bees. Even the flowers are bursting with love when they're dancing about in the breeze. Love is splish splashing through puddles and getting soaked through in the rain. Love is a rainbow that bursts through the sky when the sun begins shining again. Love is when you can't stop describing what you've been doing all day. And love is when somebody quietly listens to everything you've got to say. Love is a bedtime story that takes you to faraway lands. And love's when you want to show someone you care, so you snuggle up and hold hands. And then when you're tired and sleepy, and you're both tucked up all tight, love is that last little cuddle and kiss that helps you sleep safe through the night.
On this day of your marriage, the two of you stand somewhat apart from all other human beings. You stand in the charmed circle of your love. And this is as it should be. But love is not meant to be the possession of two people alone. Rather, it would serve as a source of common energy, as a structure in which you find the strength to live your lives with courage. From this day onward, you must come closer together than ever before. You must love one another in sickness and in health, for better and for worse. But at the same time, your love should give you the strength to stand apart, to seek your own unique destinies, to make your special contributions to the world, which is always a part of us and more than us. Being assured that you are aware of the meaning of this ceremony, I will now ask that you confirm your marriage vows. Do you, Christopher, take this woman, Lisa, to be your lawful wedded wife, to love, honor, and cherish her through sickness and in health, through times of happiness and sorrow, for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Christopher, please, place the ring upon her finger and repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
And forever pledge my devotion.
And forever pledge my devotion.
That's it? And now, do you, Lisa, take this man, Christopher, to be your lawful wedded husband, to love, honor, and cherish him through sickness and in health, through times of happiness and sorrow, for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And Lisa, please place the ring upon his finger and repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
And forever pledge my devotion. Would you now please join hands? Not yet. Who's running this show? By the act of joining hands, you take to yourselves the relation of husband and wife. and solemnly promise to love, honor, comfort, and cherish each other so long as you both shall live. Therefore, in accordance with the law of the state of Connecticut, and by the virtue of the power vested in me by that law, I do hereby pronounce you husband and wife. Congratulations. You may now share the first kiss of this new and special union. Get enough shots of that kiss? All right, we need to pose again. Christopher and Lisa, you came before us today as two single people. You will leave as a married couple, united to each other by the binding contract you have just entered. Your cares, your worries, your pleasures, and your joys you must faithfully share with each other from this day forward. The best of love, health, and good fortune to both of you always. It's official.
So if you come up at any time, oh, here we go. Once again, and the number is... That's a five. You are laughing too much. Get up right over here. Right up over this way. You kiss this gentleman right here, and let's get a picture of that one. And anyone else? And we have number three now coming up, and the number is six. You have to do it yourselves. Are you lucky? Oh. Uh-oh. You better get an even number, honey. Ah, it's a two! once again, here we go. And throwing the dice, the number turns into an 8. Once again, an 8. This is an 8. Once again, the dice are ready anytime that anyone wants them. They are right here for now. In the meantime, just one for me, please. Thank you. Give them a big round of applause. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Let me know if you want to play with the dice. If I could have your attention, please. Yes. For those of you who have never been to one of our mystery parties, it's habit. This is Lemoncello. This is Lemoncello, ladies and gentlemen. I'll ask you to please raise your glasses in one. Thank you. In one. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming to the married world the wonderful couple, Topher and Lisa Polack. To the future! That's gonna be a much better future now. Okay, who did that one? There's no leg here. I did not touch the table. That was not me. I promise nothing will go wrong. That was not me.
That was a special
effect. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, dinner will be served in just a few minutes. We're going to be starting with calling up the table, so please wait for your table number to be called before you jump up on this buffet. So once again, ladies and gentlemen, in just a few minutes, we will start. And they're just about ready. So once again, ladies and gentlemen, the buffet is open. We'll start with table 15. Let's bring table 15 up first. And it's time for me to bring up the real toast that I was asked to give earlier this evening. First of all, ladies and gentlemen, for those of you who have seen me walking around with this all night, this has been a wonderful schedule that Lisa put together. And so far, we are working at 7 minutes ahead of time. Again, I want to publicly thank you for marrying the man who needs organization more than anyone else on the planet. And it was so nice of you to take that responsibility onto yourself. Now, I'm not quite as organized as you, so hold on. That's directions. That was only up until 8:45. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, I'm 7 minutes ahead. We're okay. This one. Oh, a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away, God said, let there be lips, and then there were. And they were good. Oh, I'm sorry, I saw John Swanson. I thought we were doing Rocky Horror again. John Swanson is not only a justice of the peace, ladies and gentlemen, he's the best riffraff this side of the Mississippi. This must be the one here. This office is a place of business. No, that's a script. Ah, this is the one. This is the one. I made a promise to Lisa and Topher, Christopher, yeah. Chris. What the hell are you calling yourself this week? God almighty. How many times in one life can you change your damn name? Chris, Christopher, Topher, what are you just going to call yourself next? Now, once again, I made a big promise to you that nothing like what we do for a wedding show would happen at your wedding. We do a show, ladies and gentlemen, called Murphy's Wedding, The Law, Not the Family. In our show, anything that can go wrong for the poor bride does.
And I made a promise that nothing like that would ever go wrong here tonight. And I think we've held up on that promise. First of all, your parents are still here and are doing fine. In Murphy's wedding, they've had an accident. They're in the emergency room, and the cake and the flowers were also destroyed in the accident. So congratulations, we made it through step one. Now, when I said the cake was also destroyed in the accident, let me tell you about that. They had a beautiful wedding cake in Murphy's wedding, but unfortunately that was destroyed in the accident, which injured the parents. The cake that they were able to find was the only cake left at Stop and Shop. And it said, Happy Bar Mitzvah Adolfo. Now, first of all, Adolfo and Bar Mitzvah, I can't get that concept. But that was, you are definitely going to have a much more beautiful cake than something that says Happy Bar Mitzvah. Now, I also want to say a little something about your sister, the maid of honor. Laura, thank you. Thank you, thank you. It has been a lot of fun working with you tonight, because in our show, ladies and gentlemen, the maid of honor never stops crying. She goes around from table to table screaming, I'll never find a man of my own. I'll never get married. And spends the entire night bugging everybody at the wedding. So a big hand for Laura for just being a brilliantly beautiful woman. And last of all, in our wedding show, ladies and gentlemen, the wedding planner is called Mr. Tony, with an I. And I'm telling you, there was no Mr. Tony here tonight. Unfortunately, I'm having a real hard time keeping it together. And I just want to say that I see you. They're just so beautiful. Let's hear it. Ladies and gentlemen, raise your glasses and clap your hands for our couple. Please raise your glasses in honor of the happy couple of the day. Ladies and gentlemen, once again to Tova and Lisa. Let's hear it for them. Happy, happy years. If you have half the marriage I have, you have a beautiful life ahead of you. Thank you for inviting me, and thank you for letting me be part of this ceremony today. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, give them another big round of applause. And now, if you'd like to join the line for a second round, please join the line. No table numbers will be called. So once again, even though you stole a cupcake, we're going to let you go first. So table one, desserts will be open in just a second. We're going to let Greg.
That's like incredible. Oh. 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 right down. So that's why we picked that song. You may now take your seat. If you will, thank you. That's our couple who have been married tonight can finally get a break. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, if you have been married 1 year or two, you may now take your seat. If you have been married for less than 5 years, ladies and gentlemen, you have to take your seat. Couples that have been married between 5 and 10 years now take your seat. Anyone married 10 to 12 years, anyone under 12 years, take your seat. That was a good flourish, by the way. Very good. 15 years, ladies and gentlemen, anyone married under 15 years, take your seat. Anyone married under 20 years. Under 20 years, take your seat now, please. Anyone married under 25 years, now take your seat. Under 25 years, take your seat, please. Those folks who are still up here, yes, let's give them a big round of applause, because that's 25 years plus right now. That means half the people up here may have actually participated in a dance marathon back in the 20s. Now, once again, anyone under 25 years, have a seat, please. Going up now to 27, if you've been married under 27 years, have a seat. Getting up there now, ladies and gentlemen, if you have been married less than 30 years, have a seat. Anyone less than 30 years, have a seat. We're going higher now, ladies and gentlemen, because once again, when you're up to 30 years, we gotta hurry this along. So, anyone under 35 years, please take your seat. Under 35, give them a big round, they've got it up there. We're getting to those incredible numbers, ladies and gentlemen, the people who have been together for so long. Under 40 years, if you have been married under 40 years, have a seat. And not one couple moved. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're celebrating under 45 years, have a seat. Under 45, we have three couples remaining. Oh, I'm sorry, there you are. Four couples. Got it.
You're all sinners.
Well, we're going to go for the big 5-0. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have been married under 50 years, have a seat. We have found our couple, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, 58 years together, please give it a big round of applause to the happiest couple on the planet. 58 years and just a number of hours right together in the same picture. Give them both a big round of applause.